Ladies and gentlemen, today's event is a celebration. And in my mind, it's a celebration of promises that have been kept. It's a celebration of a tried-tested leadership that has passed with flying colors. It is a celebration of a leadership that cares for its people from all walks of life. It is also a celebration of the men and women of this country from all walks of life that demonstrate that hard work does pay. And so I know we didn't come with our dancing shoes today, but I truly hope that each one of us will be in a celebratory mood, because indeed what we witness today and what we will witness is exciting, because it's one of those things where when you work, it will show. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you, and I truly hope that you will enjoy yourself. May I give a little warning, but please be on your best behavior, because this event is being broadcast live as we speak, so I hope you will put on your lovely smiles. You already look at your best, so I hope that the smiles will complement your good looks this afternoon. However, I'm not fit enough to welcome you very well, so allow me to invite our host minister, serving police minister, Honourable Dr. Davi-tech-media, to come and give us the welcome remarks. A big hand for the minister as he comes to the meeting. Thank you.
His Excellency the President of the Republic of Zambia, President Davi-tech-media, Honorable Minister for Livestock and Fisheries, Professor Lungu, Presidential Affairs Minister, Honorable fellow members of the Central Committee of the Patriotic Front, Senior Party Official President, the Permanent Secretary of Southern Province, PS Fisheries, senior government officials, the management of the Yalelo and the cooperatives of Kamimbi and Buyantanshi. May I simply say all protocols observed, ladies and gentlemen. It is a delight today for us in Southern Province to host the head of state and to come and support us in the fisheries sector. We are a very proud province that such a pilot project involving two cooperatives managed by women are taking place in Southern Province. Your Excellency, allow me to just highlight a few important milestones that your government has scored in Southern Province. We are very proud, sir, that the set of the art, Kazungula Bridge will soon be opened. Thank you, sir. We're very proud that you chose to bring it to this province, and it is in order that we keep it a round of applause. Your Excellency, roads are taking shape everywhere. Schools, hospitals are being built. I can go on and on, bus stops. Southern Province is taking shape. The foundation has been laid for the development process of Southern Province that will contribute into turning Zambia into a middle-income economy. And Southern Province, as it stands now, Your Excellency, is the third largest provincial economy. And this only happened during your tenure of office. And we give all the credits to you for lifting the economy of this country through energy, investments through roads and all manner of infrastructure. And so, Southern Province is for Edgar only. Ladies and gentlemen, we are also proud to announce Fevayawayawe. I know some don't go to that. It's Fevayawayawe here. That Fevayawayawe has come through very good rains to an extent that we do not expect load shedding this year. The Kariba Dam is filling up very well, and we expect to reach 80% capacity of the dam and perhaps beyond, compared to last year's 49%. The province has recorded a bumper harvest, and we will continue recording bumper harvest and make us very proud by becoming one of the major food baskets of this land. Because of the very good rainfall volumes that we receive, the fish produced in the natural water bodies has increased in tonnage. Because when that water comes, it's coming with very fertile debris, which is fertilizing the plankton, the algae, and all forms of plant biomass in the water bodies, which is supplementing a fish nutrition. And I do also believe that that same experience will help those that are involved in cage fishing to produce fish at a much lower cost because of the supply from the natural water body. We are also happy that we are now beginning to utilize our main water bodies to the benefit of the people of this land. Sir, this is not my day. I just wish to say to everyone, welcome to Southern Province, and we're very proud to host you here in Siavonga. Come again, we need your kwacha. Bring your kwacha back, we are invited. The economy of Siavonga, the economy of Livingstone, is a cash economy that depends on domestic tourism. So I want to encourage everyone to come back, we'll negotiate discount packages for you. Come with your families. Today you came alone, but please come back with your families. Southern Province welcomes you through me, and I wish to thank His Excellency for choosing to be with us for all this long this morning. Thank you, sir. I'm a proud minister. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chairman. Sometimes I feel like saying doctor, for the degrees I need. All right, our next set of speakers are our cooperative partners, and we are very grateful to our older friends, Yalelo, ETG, and Atlas Mara. And I will be calling on the chief executive officers to come and give their remarks, starting with Mr. James Coney, and he will be followed by Yalelo chairman, Mr. Fisher Mare. And we will end that session with Mr. Raj Ganapati, the CEO of Yalelo. So give your hand, put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as we welcome Mr. James Coney. Atlas Mara, come and speak.
Good afternoon, all. I am very keen to show my smile if I could. I have put down my mask, but I do not. Because as already said, this is a great moment of celebration. I'd like to start once again by recognizing the presence of His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Zambia, Mr. Lungu, and allow me to write on the protocols that have been laid out by the Master of the Ceremony. This afternoon, again, it's an honor for us to be in Siavonga and to be given the opportunity to interact with yourself. On our last visit, as Atlas Mara, we had the privilege to partner as well as contribute to the empowerment of Buyantanshi and Kamimbi cooperatives, as well as to witness the commissioning of that latest innovation that we saw again this morning, by Yale Limited, which is the automated fishing and harvesting vessel. As Atlas Mara, we are partnering with our other partners to make sure that we contribute to the development of aquaculture in Zambia. Today, as we witnessed the outcome of that initial investment and the hard work that has gone into bringing it to this level, I must say that it filled us with immense pride, and I would like us to take a moment to congratulate the two cooperatives as well as the supporting partners. Your Excellency would like to applaud you and the government for the strides that you have made in promoting agriculture and aquaculture sectors. We have taken note that you continually promoted investment in these areas and that this is leading to the country attaining its goal of having food security. But it's also, in addition to this, creating opportunities for additional value addition, as well as creating a base from which we can begin to go beyond food security and begin to look at exporting these foods and making agriculture and aquaculture a cornerstone of our export-oriented trade. Your Excellency and distinguished guests of Atlas Mara, we have been committed to supporting agriculture, particularly through the FICI. You will recall that we were the first bank as Bank APC to introduce the cards that farmers used to use in order to pay their contributions and be able to access the farming input. We have evolved with government as the plan has changed and it's come to a point where, you know, we are now supporting the latest program that is in place through the Ministry of Agriculture. Your Excellency, the empowerment scheme that we have noted today and the progress that we have seen should continue to be supported so that we can have this group become an example to everybody else on what people with little skills sometimes can be taught to do something and they can do it well and they can make progress for themselves. Today we are happy to note that our contribution has resulted into this success and I am happy to announce that we would like to make a further contribution to Buyantanshi and Kamimbi cooperative and therefore pledging to contribute a further 50,000 kwacha, which will bring the total contribution by Atlas Mara to this project to 100,000 kwacha. We hope to continue to support these, you know, these activities as well as financial literacy for the team so that they can not just do the business but also begin to know when they have made a profit and when they have made a loss. Your Excellency, allow me to congratulate the two communities and to thank you and the government and all our other stakeholders that we partnered with in order to make this a success. I do hope that other communities and other cooperatives will emulate them and also enter upon this enterprise in order to make themselves self-sustainable. I wish to lastly wish the Buyantanshi and Kamimbi cooperatives much more success for the future, and congratulations for being pioneers in demonstrating that this kind of enterprise can work. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I don't know whether it's the effects of the water or the heat, but we are not in celebratory mood, ladies and gentlemen. Can we give Atlas Mara another big round of applause? Thank you. Mr. Mara, Chairman of the Island, a big hand for him as he comes ready to give him for the first of his life.
Good afternoon, Your Excellency the President of the Republic of Zambia, the Davi-tech-media Lungu, Honorable Professor Lungu, Minister of Fisheries and Livestock, the Minister of Southern Province, Honorable Honorable Cabinet Minister of State House, permanent secretaries and senior government officials, the Patriotic Front officials present, the Buyantanshi and Kamimbi cooperative representatives present, And let me not forget my fellow co-sponsors present here, and one of our guests, Mr. Michael Press from the Caribbean, present. And let me simply say, distinguished ladies and gentlemen and members of the press, I have promised to be very short in my speech, because the MC, Your Excellency, was saying that every time I see His Excellency, Siyabonga, I get so excited and overwhelmed that I just talk and talk and talk. But today, the excitement has overwhelmed me. And I wish on behalf of my executive team at Yalelo to extend a happy welcome to you and all those who are celebrating, congratulations. We hope that our event here, which has been done with input from so many other people, is successful, but does not you miss the point why we are here. Your Excellency, permit me please to say we are here because of the Buyantanshi and Kamimbi cooperatives. It is just a word out there, Buyantanshi and Kamimbi cooperatives. But behind this are individuals, and their names are Beauty Mwelwa, Lakich Beleme, Mary Namtowe, Jessica Mwanza, Priska Katele, Agnes Ngosa, Fanaka Chimunya, Regina Namtowe, Baron Chipelene, Anna Chekecheke, Mary Zalimwemwe, Loveness Mumba, Moses Kaela, Antoinette Wale, Dyson Tembo, Mumba Kaela, Miriam Mansa, Kunda Waria, Janet Mwape, Tamara Koma. Your Excellency, why I've read out those names? It is because this day is there in their honor and in their appreciation of what they have done. But importantly, the other person who is here is yourself. Your Excellency, this is symbolic because these women, simple as they are, faceless as they are, poor as they are, living in Kamimbi, have brought the whole presidency of the country here. And to do what? The whole presidency of the country, out of 18 million people, you are here because of your simplicity and because of your care that the littlest people, the most inconsequential people, matter to you. And that is what leadership and presidency is all about. If you can care, if you can care for those small people, if you are able to reach out to those small people out there, then you are able to rule with kindness, with care, and with wisdom. We thank you for you being here and for caring for the nameless people. And what does that do? It gives hope even to those who are seeing us today, that if we have the hope of achieving what our friends have, then we'll be able to do so. I thank you once again for gracing our presence here and for honoring those little people out there. Sir, Your Excellency, invited guest, I have been given 15 minutes, but I'll just take 2.5 minutes because I want to cede my other 2 minutes to one of our colleagues. And the reason is, this is the Zambian thing. We are welcoming to foreigners, whether they are bad or good. This particular brother of ours, he has come from the Caribbean, and I seek your indulgence, Your Excellency, in breaking protocol. But since I have been allocated this little time, I want to give him 2 minutes so that he can tell us how welcoming and what an investment, what a conducive investment environment Zambia is. I cede my little time to Mr. Michael Press so that you can say hello and also say the bad or good things about our country. But if you say bad things, you're not giving. Your Excellency, with your permission, if Mr. Press can say one or two things, just 1 minute. Michael, I've already acknowledged the protocols, so just say thank you. Thank you. Your Excellency, Honourable Ministers, all persons observed, I stand unique in this room as being somebody who has made an investment in Zambia, made an investment in Investors Bank, and I stand in front of you, and you probably ask yourself why. Throughout my 25 years of doing business throughout Africa, there's no country, possibly in Africa, that I haven't done business. My investments have been hallmarked by one thing, the audacity of the statement, along with the audacity of the intention. I see Zambia as not being a landlocked country, but being a land-linked country. A country where opportunity literally abounds. This morning was a testament to that feeling. I immediately saw the opportunity. I immediately approached the minister and I said to her, can you imagine if you can scale this opportunity that we've seen this morning, instead of there being one opportunity, make them a series of opportunities. A series of opportunities in which investors like myself, steeped in financial services, see the platform to grow and create scale. The Honourable Minister referred to food security. It's in the offing. As an investor, as a businessman, what do you look for? You look for the enabling environment, you look for a welcome greeting, and you look for executive leadership that has vision, good intention, and direction for the country. Your Excellency, I thank you for that. I thank you for welcoming me. I just want to make one statement before I leave the podium. The world is about to enter the next super cycle of commodities. The future is underpinned by two commodities actually, but one main one. And that's a commodity that Zambia has in abundance. And that commodity, as I'm sure you well know, is copper. The phones with all we have, the satellites which are going up in the sky, EV cars, improved telecommunications, they are all underpinned by this one resource. Our investment in Investors Bank is hinged upon three things. Repivoting the bank, changing the bank's offering from what it today being a brick and mortar offering, but creating a robust fintech platform to serve all customers. Customers like we've seen this morning, urban professionals, high net worth individuals, creating a pipeline of offering that can appeal, understanding, and I wish all of you to understand, Zambia is a hub. It is a land-linked country. Our intention is to establish first national footprint, regional footprint, and thereafter
international footprint. We have a tremendous opportunity. We look to the future, and I thank all of you, and Your Excellency, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Mr. President. And on that note, Your Excellency, I wish to thank you for your coming once again and for this opportunity for us to honor the Kamimbi and the Buyantanshi cooperatives. On behalf of Yalelo, welcome and let us continue celebrating success. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mori, Your Excellency. Mr. Mori is too smooth to manage. But thank you so much for the support, Mr. Mori and the team. Please allow me to invite ETG CEO, Mr. Wright, to come and give his remarks. So please give him a big round of applause. We can do better than later in the day. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Zambia, Honorable Minister, and other government officials, CEOs of various companies, Buyantanshi and the Kamimbi Women's Cooperatives, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. President, may I join other speakers before welcoming you once again to see Bunga. But this is the time to celebrate the fruits of your work, which you have been changing the lives of the community. Mr. President, this is a happy day for us as ETG, and we share your joy in celebrating the results of efforts. For so many projects that you have been done, ETG and myself in particular, we are able to relate your work personally. I come from communities which believe in empowering people. I stand here to represent my chairman, Mr. Mahesh Patel, who believes with us in empowering a small world of farmers in a rural area. This we believe, Mr. President, this is a key elevation of poverty. By increasing the income per dollar among the small world of farmers, and creating a middle economy and creating a job, we proud to be a part of the President's fish farming initiatives, and we witness its success today. It has always been said that the best way to empower a man is to teach them how to fish and not to give them a fish. This is what you have done, Mr. President. And we have, and we will always stand ready to support you as ETG. In the harvest we are making today, ETG provided an integrated farming approach and donated maize seed and fertilizer to supplement the income of the cooperative's members. Each member was able to harvest 20 bags of 50 kg maize, which represents more than a 70% increase in the yield when compared to the previous year in CEO district. Because of this success for this project, we would like to reassure you, Mr. President, that we are ready to put the same amount of the support in the coming farming season. The success story of the initiatives and investment you have made in the lives of the women cannot be overemphasized. Our women and youth had a lost hope when the first attempt was made in the fish farming was not successful some 13 years ago. With your leadership, Mr. President, our women and youth back into the thriving fish farming business. And we are looking forward to the time that many communities will follow your leadership, begin to learn how to fish, then expecting the fish from the government or the fishers. The yield we harvested today, 36 tons will not only change the lives of 22 members of cooperative members, and it will also change the lives of many community people in the town and province. We can only pray, Mr. President, that your office continues to support vulnerable communities and afflicting the spirit of humans and the youth in Zambia. From EPT, we pray for your long life. Once again, we want to assure you that we shall now engage the business globally to help support that affords your administrations in changing the lives of our citizens, even as you continue your transforming the country. This presidential reform initiatives founded by yourself should be become an example how to continue the transforming the lives, uplifting the rural smallholder farmers, elevating the poverty across the country by introducing the high value and improved agriculture products, which is the sustainable and the hope of the future, not just for the Zambia, but also as a whole Africa. With that few notes, God bless you, Mr. President. God bless our country. God bless Zambia. I thank you.
Thank you very much. I think that further donation for the next cycle, ladies and gentlemen, deserves a very warm and loud applause. Thank you. Thank you very much. That's what happens when you get good friends. They support you and support you all. Thank you so much to all our corporate partners. It is now my honor and privilege, ladies and gentlemen, to invite our Minister of Fisheries and Livestock, Honorable Professor Kandolo MP, to come and speak to us, and then she will call upon His Excellency. A big hand for the Honorable Minister of Fisheries and Livestock. Thank you.
That have supported And I want to admit this afternoon that I'm one minister who's always been asking, where are the private sector? Because I haven't seen them. But at least from the time we walked this journey of excellence from 20th November 2020, I saw three companies that were practically supporting an initiative which is indeed turning around the lives of our people. And I say this because when I trained abroad, Your Excellency, and worked in London, we never bought a single piece of equipment in the hospital where I worked. Everything was brought in by private companies, and they made their money through other things like reagents and other support systems. But what I've seen in Zambia, despite of the many companies that we have, is that very little social corporate responsibility go to our people. So I think today's event is an example to many private sector players in Zambia that just a very little contribution can turn around the lives of our people. And what am I saying? Your Excellency, this initiative today is harvesting 36 tons of fish. And if we translate into money, Your Excellence, that's 1,160,000. 1,160,000 kwacha. That's what the two cooperatives work away with. So for me, as your minister, I cannot thank you more for this initiative, and I cannot thank the cooperative partners more, because they've done something practical that will never be forgotten by the two cooperatives, Kamimbi and Buyantanshi. But furthermore, Your Excellence, when you have driven this agenda for cooperatives, a lot of Zambians have not warmed up to it. So the impact of what is happening today is not the money, Your Excellence, that is going to be two cooperatives. It is a practical example to the people of Zambia that come together, form cooperatives, form clubs, and get into initiatives that will translate not only into wealth creation, but food security, and in turn promote nutrition for our people in Zambia. Your Excellency, as your minister, we have identified cage farming as important. And right now, we have about 978 cages around, and 667 are here in Sierra Leone, which translates into 64%. Your Excellence, we are not only stopping at that. We have also thought that we need to look at other systems beyond cage fishing and bone fishing. We are exploring the possibility of tanks, which can be kept even in the backyard of an individual. The whole idea, Your Excellence, is to walk your talk that this country is not poor and should not even appear on any list of poor countries around the world. God has not only given us a geographical location, and was said by the CEO from Invest Trust that land brings us to 8 countries physically, but 10 countries technically, because Rwanda and Burundi are all separated to us by the time. We have 40% of Africa to water. And Your Excellence, we have all the natural resources God has given us. And as I've said in many other forums, when we die from Zambia, God is going to ask us, what did you do with my resources? But I can assure you that the patriotic front, it's not even going to hell, it will be maybe just a finger, because you have led the way to show the people of Zambia that infrastructure development is key. Separating the Ministry of Fisheries and Livestock was an important decision, because it has brought to the attention of Zambians the importance of livestock and fish farming. To continue shepherding us, your shepherds, to walk with you and make sure that we turn this country into a breadbasket. Make sure that this country is removed from the list of poor countries as you walk into a developed country. Your Excellency, my role is just to play ground for your great speech which you are waiting for. It's indeed my rare honor and privilege to ask you to come and speak to your people.
I launched this project under the presidential initiative. by stocking 6 fish cages with 108,000 fingerlings for the two cooperatives. Today, I'm back to witness the fish harvest in order to complete the cycle and demonstrate the success of this project. Oftentimes, we launch projects, but we do not show the progress made after commissioning. This one is different, and I chose to make it show. So let me congratulate all those who have made this possible. Yes. Success has many parents, and if I mention all those who succeeded and contributed to the success story, I'll be found wanting because all of us are part of the success story. So all those who participated and have been noted, such as ETG, Atlas, Yalelo, and others mentioned, we know that there are many others behind those names. Please, we say congratulations to all of you.
Now what is it to call us by ETG?
Ladies and gentlemen, results of initiatives like this give me comfort that Zambia can be self-sufficient in fish production and become a net exporter. I am happy to learn that in 2020, Zambia produced an estimated 45,670 tons of fish from aquaculture, representing 18% improvement from the 2019 aquaculture production, which was estimated then at
38,800 tons.
In 2019, we were at 38,000 tons. In 2020, we were at 45,670.
That was a big jump.
Especially if you consider that in 2011 we were at
10,520 tons.
This increase between 2011 and 2020 is because my government has put in place a robust program for aquaculture production across the country, ensuring that no one is left behind.
President yakabika imachirirana pamiri mwe yakatitwa ikutekwa ikuzuvinga nzwi kuyande tiritendelete nutuone ndeve yakabika zinto zakatitwa ikutekwa tuzuve zvizhinji kuti zvidasane.
Numbers don't lie, and when we show you what we have done, we say we are boasting. But what is that we boast about when we tell you the truth? And citizens, if you're telling the truth in Boston, then allow me to boast. But I didn't intend to boast, I just wanted to tell you, because you keep saying, so that I'm up for our
own
So we're not boasting, we're just pointing.
But the funny thing is that we do it to Tondega, we have to change our world, not just like to eat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the very same approach in the implementation of the fisheries and agriculture subsectors are bearing fruit. And this is why my government attaches great importance to the fisheries subsector. And it's for this reason that I split the Ministry of Agriculture into two, agriculture and fisheries and livestock on one hand. And this is why we're getting these good results. So those of my friends in the political ring who are saying that when, if I told them to form government, they made the Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries and Livestock. I want to tell them we tried that before, didn't work. Anyway, since the politician who said this is a personal friend, I'm saying this public and inviting him home this evening because we can talk more about this. He doesn't wait. We realize the role the fishery subsector plays in providing not only protein but income to our people, and that's why we have set it aside. That's why we have continued supporting it as a ministry. We know the importance of livestock, too.
Please, I want to work with Zimbabwe.
Especially here in Southern Province. And the good thing is that my brother, to say this time from Southern Province, I'm the engine in the robust debate this evening. I hope he's listening.
So, what do you want to say? I'm going to say,
in Southern Province, livestock is a very important sector. So it's a good thing that we set it aside and look after it together with fisheries and money is very well as
well.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in order to maintain the momentum of sustainable development of fisheries and aquaculture, I am now directing the Honourable Minister for the Ministry of Fisheries and Livestock to urgently bring to Cabinet a memorandum on the establishment of the Fisheries and Aquaculture Development Fund in line with the Fisheries
Act of 2022.
I heard directly from the minister that the 23.7 million United States dollar aquaculture seed fund, which I launched in Lungu and Chief Kanyama's chiefdom on 30th May 2020, be part of the Fisheries and Aquaculture Development Fund. The aquaculture and the fisheries development fund, which we served in Kanyama, is under the 50,089,906 dollars, which is seed fund under the framework of the Zambia Aquaculture Enterprise Development Project. It is co-funded by the African Development Bank and the Zambian government, and I'm sure our partners will not object to my proposal that this fund be put under the Fisheries and Aquaculture Development Fund in line with our laws pursuant to the Fisheries Act number 22 of 2011.
Who's the board? The decimal in America as 50.8. I got a zero with Andorra, Indam with African Development Bank, a bank in Portugal, but I am not a man for me. Nimputo Yamana, I want to go to the young is here. It would be car, which in Costa, Jamsby, it would take one. The woman, who got one man is meaning that was done.
If our partners will have difficulties with this arrangement, please bring them to my office as soon as possible. We'll talk about this.
And I will put my name on it. Now, Java should be. But yet, the office won't be able to answer.
I'm very sure, ladies and gentlemen, that this move will ensure a self-sustaining fisheries and aquaculture subsector.
Oh, you know, there's a little bit of a thing. We are going to talk around the day. Come out.
I'm saying this, ladies and gentlemen, because we have to look within ourselves in resource mobilization first before we seek help elsewhere. Ladies and gentlemen, the country's fish demand continues to rise due to increased human population and growing interest in people for healthy foods such as fish. Yes, Zambians who know, we are coming to know that fish is good for their bodies.
I was one of the
In this regard, I would like to encourage the private sector to actively participate in aquaculture production. The private sector should be involved in fingerling production, fish feed production, fish processing, and value addition and marketing.
Ladies
and
If we become money out, got to guide them with agency. If we let money out, to get my fight out, this is the last guy who got to become able to govern as somebody. Aku ingin cakap sesuatu kasih baca, ingin cakap sesuatu kasih kasih tahu, ingin kasih cara kau tu. Kau orang pun dia, kau ini jadi jauh. Kita pun kita malu sesuatu ini kita baca nanti ni lah.
Right now, we have a deficit in fish feed in the country because of the demand by the various groups of people who are taken to fish farming.
Kau yang nasi ini, cakap dia jangan sih. Jambo ni nami siasa ni, kama wangu tibandu Ivanjila mumakwewo, anjila kumi moyo wa usilansu, wa uvulansu, wa uvulansu Aboko, chako ya chabani kajaje.
So I ask our friends here, Ititi, Atrasmana, Yalero, and all those of us who are interested in fish farming to look into the various areas in which they can invest more money and ensure that we have a complete cycle, that is the production figuring, production of fish feed, processing fish, and indeed other value-additional aspects in the fishing sector. There is money to be made in fish farming. However, we look at it. My government, ladies and gentlemen, is poised to produce 162,000 tons of fish from aquaculture by 2025 to meet our domestic requirements of ensuring that every Zambian consumes at least 12 kilograms of fish annually. To achieve this, we will require not less than 800 million fingerlings a year and 242,000 tons of fish feed a year.
No, to see I'm when we have to see this one, 800 million, it would take one. When the Nigeria to Garamu, table is 242,000.
Apart from all this, the export market is also yearning and yearning for the fish feed, the fish and feed for this country.
When the Babo, Master Art is in the world today. About our Master Art, this is the Jabo Jansi, and see a little bit of the Jabo Jansi. Tapi this is juga untuk kita bantu bantu apa mesti semua kita bantu nak dia.
We are exporting fish feed, and partly we are exporting fish. We have a deficit still as much as we are exporting. So even if you come into the market with a view to export, you will find the market. If you come to the market for locals and for so you find the market. What I'm saying here, ladies and gentlemen, is that you are showing of the huge domestic and huge export markets, especially that the country is
bandwidth.
Right now we are working balancing act to make sure that we have some feed left for use in the country as we continue exporting because we cannot allow ourselves to use the export market. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, let me take this time to congratulate the cooperative for the hard work exhibited in managing the fish, which we stopped on 24th November 2020. Without your commitment, this day would have not been possible. I look forward to more future harvests by your cooperatives and those which are coming on board.
Kamimbi alimaba Buyantanshi kwamba utaomba kunyongoma mbele moyo. This is the first time I'm going to go back in 4 November. So na bole ni kitu zote ngo. Nicho ni mtatengo na nalione. Abobo atuzumana na mbele moyo.
I wish to age I'm going to be
and I say God bless you all. Let's enjoy our lunch. Thank you so much.